All right, Scott, I think I've got this one for you.
It's for me?
That's for you.
How do you know?
It says, what is the difference between the Non-Profit Success Pack and Enterprise Edition, I guess, of Salesforce?
Okay. So this actually is a point of confusion that comes up a lot. I feel like this is probably something we answer once a week, if not more often. So Salesforce has multiple tiers in terms of its core CRM products. So we've got Group Edition, Professional Edition, Enterprise Edition, Unlimited Edition. Those are all different levels of licensing that get you different functions within the core platform. So, and then when we talk about Nonprofit Success Pack or Nonprofit Starter Pack, as it used to be called, or sometimes we hear it termed as NPSP, NPSP is something that overlays on top of the core Salesforce platform. So to say, do we have Enterprise Edition or do we have Nonprofit Success Pack? Those are two completely different things that are complementary to one another. They're not divergent from one another. In fact, we need to be on the Enterprise Edition in order to install NPSP into the environment. I want to take that just one step further. Salesforce, through their foundation, has for pretty much forever given nonprofits a product grant, and part of that product grant includes 10 free enterprise licenses of the Salesforce.com core CRM application. So as a nonprofit, you are getting Nonprofit Success Pack as an option to add on to your Enterprise Edition. In other words, Enterprise Edition is the foundational layer, and you may choose to add NPSP on top of that, but you don't necessarily have to.
So I think Scott, out of all the three of us, has had the most Salesforce experience. And so I've got a trick question for you, Scott. Can you have Professional Edition and also use the Nonprofit Success Pack? And I don't know the answer, by the way.
I'm going to say with like 98% certainty that you cannot install NPSP into a professional environment because it's going to include a number of Apex triggers and some other things that I don't think you're going to be able to install into that professional environment.
Sounds like something we should try for fun.
Pretty sure Scott's right too. And I think it does come down to the custom code. You cannot have Apex code or Visual Force pages within the Professional Edition.
There you go.